Sick and tired of Monica? Don't just sit there. We'll tell you what to do. A Times exclusive, the secret life of Suarez's petition circulator. And dig this, Florida's first subway may tunnel under Miami. I'm Amy Atkins, and these are the Times.
It's not drive-bys, but drive-throughs that some lawmakers are trying to outlaw. We'll tell you why. Meet a family that's so light-headed, their house is electric. And lingerie online. Victoria's Secret hits cyberspace.
Topping the Times, it's wake-up time in America. So get off your couch, grab a pen, and get ready to do something really democratic. 4 days from now, the full House of Representatives will vote on whether to impeach our president. The polls overwhelmingly show most Americans do not want that to happen. And yet, it looks more and more like it will. No matter which side you're on, now would be a good time to have your voice heard. So in the interest of participatory democracy, we're going to make it easy for you. Here's the phone number for Congress, 202-225-3121. Throughout the show, we'll be giving you the names of every undecided representative in the House. You can reach all of them at www.house.gov. Remember, you do have a choice. You can do nothing. But then you can't complain if we're still talking about this next year and the markets crash and the Supreme Court comes to a halt along with the Senate and the White House and the world doesn't take us seriously and we all have to listen to more bad Monica jokes. Johnny Chung, no relation to Connie, was sentenced to 5 years probation today. The Taiwanese-born Democratic contributor pleaded guilty to making an illegal $20,000 contribution to the Clinton-Gore re-election campaign. An exclusive here, Times investigator John Mattis dug up even more dirt on one of Xavier Suarez's signature collectors, Edward Smith, who, according to a handwriting expert, forged 44 of the signatures on Suarez's petition for a new election, has a rap sheet almost as long as Suarez's petition. He was arrested last week for trying to mug someone in downtown Miami. John Mattis got a hold of his rap sheet. It's under the name Calvin Smith, and it's chock full of convictions. Lewd and lascivious conduct with a child, grand larceny, burglary, and selling drugs, among other things. Mattis asked the election supervisor about the qualifications for a petition circulator.
So a child molesting heroin dealer could actually be someone circulating petitions?
Absolutely. There's no rules on who can circulate a petition, only on who can sign a petition.
Comforting. Smith has lots of AKAs, Edward Smith, Edward J. Smith, Anthony Dwight Smith, Calvin Smith, Edward Jeffrey Smith, or even Edward Calvin Smith. Commissioners vote tomorrow on a major engineering work for Dade County, a new underwater tunnel for a subway. It's long, it goes deep, it's a tunnel from the Orange Bowl to the Port of Miami, all for just $250 million, a small part of a $4 billion five-year highway project. The plan also includes a new rail line, carpool lanes, and a new passenger baggage check for Miami International Airport. The county will vote on the plan tomorrow.
It encompasses using similar technology. We've discovered that it may be used as was used in the English Channel, a boring technique for the actual tunnel.
Boring drilling, not boring in concept.
Boring in drilling, yes.
Good question. Tomorrow on the Times, find out who's paying for the tunnel and why there's already an investigation of the project. Florida Senator Bob Graham went postal today, working as a mailman at the Doral branch. Graham likes to work real people jobs to show he's not just some remote politician who stages publicity stunts to get people to think he's just not some remote politician. His office says he did not wear a Kevlar vest for this, possibly his most dangerous assignment yet. He lived through the entire day, the busiest post office day of the year. There's safety in numbers, at least that's what the FBI wants you to deduce from their latest crime statistics. The feds say the nation's so-called serious crime rate is down 5% this year. Robberies are down 11%, murders 8%. Aggravated assault and rape, both down 5%. Auto theft is down 8%, and burglary, 3%. Some of the reasons cited for the drop on crime, more cops, tougher gun laws, stiffer sentences for violent criminals. Critics say, despite the drop, America is still number one.
And if you compare the rates of homicide victimization of young men in this country to 22 other industrialized countries, the U.S. is number one.
President Clinton is in the Middle East to get the peace process back on track. The Palestinians have agreed to scrap the clause in their national charter that calls for the annihilation of Israel. As you might imagine, the Israelis are more than happy to hear that. It was one of the key Israeli demands at the Y peace talks.
You did a good thing today in raising your hands. You know why? It has nothing to do with the government in Israel.
Puerto Ricans voted not to become the 51st state yesterday. It was one of four choices on the ballot, including independence, free association, and commonwealth. More than half of the voters opted for none of the above because they didn't like the new definition of commonwealth. The vote was close. 46.5% voted for statehood. Puerto Rico will remain what it is now, a commonwealth that does not pay federal taxes and maintains its culture, Spanish language, and Olympic team. Captain Euro is being trashed. A London marketing firm created the not-so-superhero to defend the common currency and get kids excited about spending it. But after his introduction, European kids don't know Captain Euro from Captain Crunch, and he's got lots of enemies. Sir Teddy Taylor, a member of the British Parliament, said, quote, "He should be killed off. I think he's dangerous." That's what he said. When we come back, it causes air pollution, traffic jams, and obesity, and they want to ban them in Atlanta. What is it? Plus, let your fingers do the shopping at Victoria's Secret. Leisha shows you how in Showtimes.
On this day in 1970, Miami Beach residents, outraged about a condominium going up in their neighborhood, called for the resignations of four of their councilmen.
Diva. It's like your mic doesn't work. Big you need tea. Powder. Can I button this? I can't hear you.
And the hair guy's behind you.
Is he really?
Your hair looks He's very right nice, here. By the way.
It looks really, really good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So you'll be here every day.
Very smooth. It looks really nice.
Hold on, hold on. Give me some slack.
I love that.
You got to need some more slack?
There. Go. Wrap it.
I feel like so, like, super prim.
Coming out of this pack, out of this break on camera 6, and Danielle's supposed to be in the entertainment section, and there's a toss.
Where is Danielle? Toss 2?
No, there's not a toss 2 because it goes, you introduce.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And then you talk, introduce, she does the package, then she tags her package, there's a toss back.
All right. What are we doing? You're going to sit there, you do a tag, and. Governor Lawton Chiles will be laid to rest on Wednesday. The homespun politician with a cracker upbringing never lost his touch with the people. Andy Rothman met some of them.
Lawton Chiles always said he wanted to put children first, and his supporters say when it came to their health, he acted more like a parent than a politician.
He's not the politician that kissed the kid, gave it back to the parent, and then went on. Here's a man who dedicated to putting together programs and legislation that supported them.
Child advocates say the Healthy Kids program is one of Child's greatest accomplishments. The health insurance program provides inexpensive coverage to nearly 9,000 underprivileged children in Miami-Dade and nearly 70,000 to children in the state of Florida.
But really, it made a big difference in getting kids who might be missing school because of illness healthy so that they can get into school.
No one realizes that more than Geralda Dumas. Up until 2 years ago, this mother of two was raising her children, who suffer from severe asthma, with absolutely no health insurance.
If they didn't have the healthy kids, I would have been doomed. Basically, that's why I say thank you for the governor.
Today, Geralda is joining thousands of other mothers and child advocates in Florida who are remembering Governor Childs and the things he did for children.
His visionary, being a visionary to see where the needs were of the needy and trying to make programs that would fit that need and make them more accessible to people.
And child advocates like Lillian Rivera and moms like Geralda Dumas had hoped he'd continue fighting for children's rights even after leaving office. Now they're left wondering who, if anyone, will take his place.
Today, Acting Governor Buddy McKay ordered all state offices closed on Wednesday in memory of Governor Childs. When we come back, Victoria's Secret models are now available at the tip of your fingers. Plus, House of Lights. This just in from The Hague, Netherlands. A pilot there known as Captain Flintstone has been cleared for takeoff. He'd been barred from an airport in The Hague for singing the catchy theme to the Flintstones over his radio. He tied up an air traffic controller's frequency for 20 minutes, singing it over and over. Flintstones, meet the Flintstones. They're a modern Stone Age family, you know. Annoying as that was, the Dutch Council of State ruled that banning Captain Flintstone was too harsh. Had he been singing the theme to the Brady Bunch, he could have been legally shot out of the sky. Lawmakers in Atlanta are working to rid their town of a menace to society. It's an environmental hazard that can be dangerous to the health of people as well. And as Danielle Serino reports, the menace is just as prevalent in Florida as Atlanta.
Hey, if this is a drive-thru, how come I have to come to a complete stop?
That's the funny thing about drive-thrus. They were created for convenience, but they sometimes seem anything but.
How long have you been waiting on this line?
about 20 minutes.
It's a long time for fast food, but Americans are used to being in their cars, driving an average of 2 billion miles a year.
You can sit here and listen to the radio.
I've been checking my messages. I've been calling back people.
And that's one of the reasons drive-thrus are such big business. According to the National Restaurant Association, $33 billion was spent in drive-thrus last year.
Now please have your order.
But it's not just food. People will wait in line for just about anything, as long as they get to do it in their cars.
Okay, there are special prices.
Despite America's devotion to drive-thrus, communities in California and North Carolina are trying to put the brakes on them. They've banned new construction to cut down on noise and traffic. One Atlanta councilman has gone so far as to blame drive-thrus for everything from obesity to pollution.
What if I told you that if you stopped using drive-thrus, it would help cut down on ozone depletion and pollution? Would you stop using drive-thrus?
I don't think so.
And Floridians say that'll never happen here. That's probably why Florida is the only state east of Las Vegas that offers drive-thru weddings. Mort Wolfman, who runs Vows in Davie, says it's all about excitement.
The same kind of people that jump out of airplanes and get married, or they get married underwater, they just want something different.
I'd like a 6'4", brown-haired, blue-eyed, non-smoking attorney.
We sure do.
With service like that, I'd never leave my car either.
And drive-thrus are particularly popular here in Florida because Floridians spend more time in their cars than drivers in almost every other state. They log 127 million miles a year. The average American puts in only 48 million. Well, I didn't get my 6'4".
Not yet, but you put your order in.
I did.
Thanks.
Ellis Rubin, the lawyer famous for the nympho defense of Kathy Willits and the comic defense of Spider-Man, now has a new cause, racial discrimination in the American tennis circuit. Rubin represented the case of Mashiska Washington, a black player ranked 407th, who says he's been discriminated against by the tournament directors and marketing agencies. Rubin is threatening legal action, but so far it is just a threat. Based on Rubin's record and his own, Mashiska should not give up his day job if he has one. In Hollywood, it's lights, camera, action. Hollywood, Florida, lights, courtesy the Frettini family. Camera, courtesy Times photojournalist Jeff Flamer. Action, here it is.
Christmas was so boring to be Christmas with, you know, no snow, no nothing. So we start to put light and everything. And the first thing I start to put is snow on the ground.
Stand up, Blitzen, Dasher, Dancer, Prince of Vixen!
Did you plan on it being this big?
Not at all. You know, it's one obsession. Every year we want to make bigger, we want to have something new.
Sometimes people bring some things, they will leave on the door for us to fix, or their light does not work anymore.
I'm always ready to fix something, you know. I have the tester, I have the lamp. Fixing the light is the worst thing, because every day we have to fix the light. I have 50,000 to fix, so. The dancing Santa is new. It's very neat, I like him. I dance with him. And I even have some pieces. They are from my mother when she was a little girl. On the villages, we have over 500 pieces, I'm sure. And we have 22 Christmas trees.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
But the most joyful thing is to see the children. Lots of people ask questions and I don't want to answer. How much is the electric bill? And I don't want to tell them, because if they don't want to pay it, I'm not telling them. Enjoy, and if you appreciate, leave a donation for the children. Last year, we had a little boy who did bring 5 rolls of pennies wrapped. That was his saving for all year to come to bring to us. That was most important than any other thing, because that came from a little boy. Have a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, and God bless you.
You can bring donations to the home of the Frettinges at 1442 Washington Street in Hollywood. Last year they raised more than $3,000. The money goes to the Children's Home Society of Florida. Showtimes. Lisa, Woody Allen, man, I don't know what. He's getting into trouble now with his big mouth.
Although he's never really cared what the public thinks about him.
Obviously not,
true.
Yeah.
You can forget Bullets Over Broadway. Woody Allen has launched a full verbal assault on Bob Hope. The neurotic director, actor, calls the 95-year-old comic legend lazy and just awful in this week's New Yorker magazine. Allen says Hope was good at his movies early in his career, but he became lazy doing, quote, old-fashioned sketches later on. Allen, just one of several Hollywood types blasting Hope today. Comedian's former manager calls him the most self-centered person I've ever known. And his publicist of 41 years says Hope never walked past a mirror without looking at himself. Ouch. Doesn't end there either. Hope's manager says the comic used to make his writers act like trained dogs in order to get their paychecks. And you can read all about it in the New Yorker magazine this week. Nicole Kidman took all her clothes off on stage last night, but do not dispose of the Viagra quite yet.
I'm rambling, but my life is a search.
A search?
Yeah. Yeah, for a love which stays real.
Kidman, starring on Broadway in The Blue Room, is naked in the play for only about 14 seconds, and even then you can only see her from behind. While London critics called Kidman's performance pure theatrical Viagra, Tom Cruise, Nicole's husband, called the nudity tastefully done. Cruise talked after the play to a reporter from CBS This Morning.
It's incredible. You know, here's this girl from Australia, now she's on Broadway in this big hit show, and you know, the cover of Newsweek. It is incredible.
She is incredible. Cruise just one of a number of celebrities' large star-studded audience last night, many of whom paid $1,600 per ticket. Finally, a website to give naked pictures of famous people some competition. The VictoriasSecret.com site features sexy supermodels sauntering on the runway or gabbing half-dressed behind the scenes of a New York lingerie show. The most beautiful, sexiest women in the world, Karen Mulder, Rebecca Romijn, Tyra Banks, Helena Christensen, all dress up like angels on the site wearing giant white wings and pretty much little else. Oh yes, and you can also buy underwear at the site. Captain Picard can finally get that new spaceship he wanted.
Grammys, Captain. Question is, why would anyone want to create one of our village?
Star Trek Insurrection coming in strong. It's number one at the box office this weekend as the Enterprise crew searches for the Fountain of Youth. That bumps the animated flick A Bug's Life to second, and it's a chilly reception for Jack Frost, the story of a father, Michael Keaton, who comes back to life as a snowman. Star Trek Insurrection blowing away the competition, $22.5 million. A Bug's Life crawls away with $11 million in second place, and Jack Frost earns a cool but kind of unimpressive $7 million. And don't forget Amy, tonight I will also be co-hosting, filling in for Sports Town.
Speaking of impressive, I'm still waiting for that tape. Have to see it.
For Friday.
But you must have done very well, or they would not have had you back, though.
Oh, well, I'd like to think so.
Yeah.
That's a good thing.
Anything exciting coming up?
Dan Reeves, coach, Atlanta Falcons. He had quadruple bypass surgery, so we'll find out what his condition is and what effect it's going to have on the team.
All right, thanks. And for women in South Florida and everywhere, really, size does matter. The size of your hips, your waist, and your thighs. It can influence what kind of clothes you find and don't find at the mall. But as Diane Mocha reports, high fashion is becoming a growth industry.
It was pretty tough trying to stay a sample 8. I chose to transition to go as a plus size model.
Now we have high fashion for that woman.
Even in a city of anorexic looking models, the population of full figured women is increasing, and so are their options.
You can walk into this mall and there are 45 to 50 stores for the regular size woman. She has a lot of choices. The plus size woman does not have a lot of choices of where to shop.
But that's changing. Chubby couture is the latest fashion trend. And Grand Exit in Aventura Mall claims to be the first boutique in South Florida devoted exclusively to it.
And it's all because of the money, the buying power.
Less is more.
Owner Jeanette Matz wants a piece of that. She says half of all American women wear sizes 14 to 24.
And we try to fill that void in the market.
We have it right here.
Bernice Sparkman thinks it's about time. When she went from size 6 to size 14, her desire to dress sexy didn't shrink as her waistline expanded.
I'm plus size. I'm a size 12, 14, 16. Even a 24, and I am just as elegant as the woman who's a size 6.
Women like Bernice spent $650 million on plus-size clothing last year. And she says she has no plans to shed pounds and no problem dropping $1,600 on an elegant outfit. Attitudes like that should tip the scales of demand in the designer world.
When we return, your cool weather forecast is next.
I can see clearly now the rain is gone. I can see clear. I can see clearly now the rain is gone.
Break out the jackets. It finally feels like fall. Cooler air made its debut in South Florida today. The refreshing air was brought to you by high pressure to our north. We'll see the coldest lows so far this season by tomorrow morning. Most areas will be in the 40s and 50s. If you're traveling tomorrow, dress warm. Cool air will continue across the state with highs in the 50s and 60s. Across the country, the WAMI jet takes off in search of warmer air, landing in California under partly sunny skies and a high of 71. Heading up north, a definite chill is in the air for the northeast, highs only in the low 50s. Wondering about the next 5 days? It looks like the cool weather will stick around. We may see a scattered shower on Wednesday as a second cold front comes through the area, leaving us in the mid-70s for most of the week. Time's up. Happy Hanukkah. I'm Amy Atkins, and these are the Times. Good night.